Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. There are really two main causes for lines and wrinkles. Most of us are familiar with photoaging, which causes lines and wrinkles from repeated, unprotected exposure to the sun. And that causes collagen and elastic tissue in the skin to break, and that causes lines and wrinkles. But what most people don't realize is that another cause of loss or breakage, collagen and elastic fibers, is repeated motion of the skin, repeated creasing and folding, such as frowning, smiling, squinting. All of these things fold the skin back and forth, fold the collagen back and forth, and cause it to break. Let me give you some examples. This is a flat piece of paper without any folds, and I'm going to fold it. And I press on that, and now I'm going to fold it again and move my finger back and forth several times. If I open it, you can see a fold or a crease. Let me try to rub out that fold or crease. And what happens? You still have a fold, you still have a crease. And the reason is, in folding that repeatedly, I've actually broken the cellulose fibers that form the structural integrity of the paper. Well, if paper has cellulose fibers to give it integrity, our skin has collagen, which gives it structural integrity. And as a result of repeatedly folding the skin or creasing the skin, whether it's frowning or smiling, anything that does that will ultimately break the collagen fibers and therefore cause the same kind of line or wrinkle. So think of this paperclip as a collagen fiber. What happens if we fold this paperclip back and forth, back and forth? Well, after enough folds back and forth, it breaks. And that's why next to my eye, I have a fine line. It's etched there as a result of the complete destruction of some collagen there. But skin, unlike paper, skin also has elastic fibers in it. And the function of elastic fibers is to restore the shape of the skin to its natural shape. So if I take my face and I stretch it out, the elastic fibers are what brings it back. But if you repeatedly stretch elastic fibers back and forth, after a while, they get stretched out and broken. So now there are folds in this elastic band that just don't come out because they've been broken. Let me give you another example of this. This piece of paper has no folds. It's in perfect shape. But if you fold back and forth with the elastic, after a while, you can't get it to stretch out. It's deformed. And one of the main differences between paper and human skin, well, human skin, we're accustomed to repairing itself. But actually, once you've broken collagen, the skin can make a little more collagen, but it doesn't do it very well. And even worse, once you've broken elastic tissue, anytime the skin makes new elastic tissue, it never works properly. So if you need any more convincing of the value of repetitive folding of the skin and causing lines and wrinkles, take a look at the upper lip of somebody who smoked for 10 or 20 years. And I can promise you that you'll see these vertical lines etched into the upper lip as a result of smoking. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.